Yes. So we started part number one, right? That video. So did you all see my part number one, chapter number one, all chapter number one, part number one? Heat. Did you all see it? If you didn't see it, I will put the link in the description box. Okay. And please watch that first video, that means part number one video, and then come to this part number two video. Okay, this is the part number two video, and then only you will understand what I'm teaching now. Okay, because that's continuation part I'm taking, right? A continuation part I'm taking. So then only you will understand what I'm teaching now. Okay. Yeah. So today we are in part number two, and the continuation. So we studied what all the things we studied. Anyone can say what all the things we studied? Yes, we studied up to what is temperature, what is the device we use to measure the temperature, difference between hot and cold, right? Then we take an activity to show that sense of touch is not reliable or reliable. That we studied, right? Yeah. So what is the device used to measure the temperature? What is the device? It is called thermometer. Yeah, it is called thermometer. Thermometer. So, don't look in this part, okay? This part you want to look, okay? Don't read this or anything. You don't want to look in that part. That means this part up to this, you don't want to read. I'm writing this part, so you want to read only this much, okay? Yeah. So we say that this is the device used to temperature. So thermometer is a device used to temperature. Thermometer is a device used to measure the temperature of an object. Am I right? Yes. So thermometer is divided into so many thermometers. Okay. Not only one thermometer is there. So many thermometers there, okay? So many thermometers doctors are using so many thermometers, am I right? Yeah, did you all see so many thermometers for a baby? We use another thermometer for a big one. We use another thermometer for measuring and hot water. We use another thermometer like this. We use so many types of thermometer, okay? So there are so many names also for that. So but in the 7th standard, that means in chapter number 1 heat, we only studied the two types of thermometer. Okay, so what are the thermometer? What are two types of thermometer that we are going to study today? Yeah, so we will study about the two types, and one is what? Clinical thermometer, okay? Clinical thermometer. And so one is the clinical thermometer and the other one is the laboratory thermometer. That's two one we are going to study, okay? Other one is laboratory. Thermometer. Yes. So first one is the clinical thermometer and the other one is the laboratory thermometer. These two thermometer we are going to study in this chapter. Okay, so if you read this chapter in when the teacher taught you, that time you will, I think you all read, right, the textbooks. So that time you heard about the clinical and the laboratory thermometer, am I right? Yes. So we are going to study about the clinical and laboratory thermometer in this chapter. Okay, yes. So let's start. What is a clinical thermometer? Okay, what is a clinical thermometer? So let's start. A clinical thermometer means in this part, like this. Okay, a clinical thermometer is like this. So I just drawing this board, and if I can, I will be showing in the picture. Okay? Yeah. So you all can see this clinical thermometer correctly, right? Yeah. A clinical thermometer means it consists. A clinical thermometer consists of a long, narrow, uniform glass tube. It's like a not a uniform that we are wearing in our schools. Not like that. It's like a narrow uniform. That means a pakka correct length. Okay. It's not. I'm just drawing. If I think it's not a correct line, but I will be showing in the video, the picture. I will be showing in the part. Okay. This video, I will be showing the clinical thermometer photo. Okay. If it is not clear for you, this. And this I draw only, right? Then the clear picture I will be showing in this video.
Friends, this is the clinical thermometer picture. Okay, this is the picture.
Okay, yeah. Anyway, look at your book or look at this board, anything. A clinical thermometer consists of a long, narrow, uniform. Uniform means a pakka correct length. A same length. Okay, same length, same breadth and all. It's called a uniform glass tube, uniform narrow glass tube. It is made up of a glass. So it is made up of glass. Okay, no doubts, right? That's a lot of test, but I just promise you, I will be clearing about that. Okay, yeah. So clinical thermometer, this I draw in a bigger size, but in the normally the clinical thermometer are only a short, only a little bit. Okay, it's only a little bit. But in the case of laboratory, it is a big one. That we will be studying later. So we are going to study today clinical. Okay, clinical thermometer. So clinical thermometer is a uniform narrow glass, uniform glass tube. This point you want to study, otherwise you will not understand anything. Okay, that is main thing. So I will be telling some points that you want to study clearly. Okay, yeah. So I'm rubbing. So we all know that a clinical thermometer consists of a long, narrow, uniform glass tube. And the next point we are going to study is it consists of a bulb. It has a bulb. Okay, that we all study. It has a bulb. Okay. So next point, it has a bulb at one end. Seeing in our house, not a lighted bulb. This is a bulb. Okay, this is called a bulb. Okay, this is called a bulb. So it has a bulb at one end. Okay, so this clinical thermometer has a bulb at one end. Okay, so next one, this bulb consists of a mercury. Okay, we all know, right? What is a mercury? So it's a metal liquid, right? Yeah, we all know it contains heat. So, mercury. So, this bulb consists mercury. It is very important. Okay, so in this mercury, this bulb consists of a mercury. Okay, so outside the bulb, next one, outside the bulb, after writing the text, I will be telling you. Okay, yeah, outside the bulb, a small shining thread called mercury. A small shining thread mercury can be seen. Okay, if you write like this, also correct. Mercury can be. Okay. So next, clinical thermometer. So after writing only this much, I write 1, 2, 3, 4 points I wrote. And And then first I will be discussing about this and I will be understanding what I write here. Okay, and after that I will be writing the next point. Okay, that means I think the last, not last. Yeah. Anyway, so the next point, it has a bulb at one end. We say, right? The clinical thermometer has a bulb at one end. Okay. This bulb consists of mercury. What do you mean by mercury? A mercury is a metal, right? Metal, liquid metal. Okay, it's a liquid metal that contains heat easily. Okay. It's called mercury, that we all know. This bulb consists of mercury. So outside the bulb, we can see a small shining thread. Mercury can be seen. Only a thread means, I'll be writing with this. A thread means only a small, okay. Only this much, a thread-like structure we can see. A thread of mercury, that means, so suppose see this green as mercury. Okay, so they are telling that a small shining thread-like structure, a small shining, it's like a golden color. Okay, it's golden in color, and this small shining, I have no gold color, so that's why I use a green and blue color for that. So this green color is the mercury. Suppose you think this green color is the mercury. So this is called the what? Small shining thread. You can see inside here, right? A small shining thread of mercury can be seen. Okay? Yeah. If you didn't see the mercury, tilt the mercury and then you can see. Okay? So next point, if you didn't see, it's only a, not a point if you have to write. Okay? What? If you didn't see the mercury, tilt the mercury. Okay, then tilt the mercury. Then you can suppose to see the mercury. Okay? Yes. So, you all know what you mean by tilt, right? You can, if this is a mercury, then you want to tilt it. Like upside down, you want to tilt. Then you can suppose to see the mercury. And did you see that why I'm writing here? Celsius scale. I just write here a Celsius scale. Did you all see that? Did you all notice that why I just write Celsius scale? This is a scale, right? We all know this clinical thermometer is a scale. And this scale can be read by degree Celsius. So, I'll write. Okay. This scale can be read by Celsius. So this scale can be read by Celsius scale. It has Celsius scale. What is the this is called the Celsius scale, okay? Yeah. So it is written like, what do you mean? How can we write the Celsius scale? In the short form, like this, Celsius scale, degree Celsius. Okay, degree Celsius. Think we are writing like here. Degree Celsius, we are writing like this, degree Celsius. So, this scale can be read as Celsius scale. It can be written like C at degree. Okay, degree Celsius. Okay, so this is about that, clinical thermometer. And then what more is also there? Okay. And how many numbers are there in the clinical thermometer? If you see the picture, you can understand how many numbers we can read this clinical thermometer, the temperature from 35 degrees Celsius to 42 degrees Celsius. Okay. the clinical thermometer. Reads temperature from, I will say, from, this is very important, so I am using another pen, 35 degrees Celsius to 42 degrees Celsius. Okay. I just say how we are writing this thermometer, clinical thermometer, by this Celsius, because it's a Celsius scale, so we are using C, degrees Celsius scale. Okay, so 35 degrees. The starting number is 35. Its ending number is 42. Okay, so we can read this clinical thermometer temperature from 35 to 42. This is very very important. Okay. This, there is, I know there is a lot of test in this, because it's a big chapter, and I know this is a big, lot of test is there, but I know you all understand, right? Because I just say it very clearly, and it's read clinical thermometer reads temperature from beginning is 35, ending up to 42 degrees Celsius, right? I think all clear, yes? So, I think you all understood about from this page about the clinical thermometer. What is the clinical thermometer? How it looks? I think you all understood, right? Yes. So, if you like this video, please press the like button and subscribe to my channel on the right side of this video. And press the bell icon, ding, 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 like that. And please enable the all options. Then only you will get the notifications when I upload my videos. And stay tuned to my next video, which is coming soon. That means part number 3, right? Part number 3. Yes, it will be coming. And if you have any doubts, please comment in the comment section. And share this video to all your dear friends, relatives, to all. And then what? Bye. This is Miss.